بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أحييكم بتحية الإسلام تحية مباركة ألا وهي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We start by praising and thanking Allah Ta'ala as we believe all praise and all thanks is to Him. We ask Allah Ta'ala to forgive us. We ask Allah Ta'ala His assistance. And we ask Allah Ta'ala for His protection. Protection from the evil that might be within our own selves and from the consequences of the sin that we might have committed. We know that whoever Allah Ta'ala guides, none can misguide them. But similarly, if Allah Ta'ala let a person go astray, then none is able to guide them. And we testify and bear witness that there is no one, there is nothing worthy of being worshipped except Allah Ta'ala, the creator of all things. And we testify and bear witness that Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the last and final messenger of Allah Ta'ala to mankind. I advise myself and to my brothers and sisters, as how Allah Ta'ala had advised us in the Quran, and as Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had advised us, to have taqwa. And taqwa means to be aware of Allah Ta'ala, to be God-conscious, so that one will do good at all times and stay away from that which is wrong. And we ask Allah Ta'ala to make us among the al-muttaqeen, those who are God-conscious. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would remind at the beginning of the speeches that the best of words are the words of Allah Ta'ala. They are the most truthful of words. And the best example in the religion to follow is the example of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam himself. And one of the worst things a person can do in religious matters is to change that guidance, adding to it or subtracting from it. We ask Allah Ta'ala to make us from those who love the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and abide by his teachings closely. Amin. Ya Rabbil Alameen. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, as done in our last session, inshallah I will read to you the Arabic text followed by the English translation, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم عن أبي ذر جندب بن جنادة وأبي عبد الرحمن معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال اتق الله حيثما كنت وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمهها وخالق الناس بخلق حسن رواه الترمذي وقال حديث حسن وفي بعض النسخ حسن الصحيح أبو ذر جندب بن جنادة أن أبو عبد الرحمن معاذ بن جبل radiyallahu anhuma reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fear Allah wherever you may be, follow up an evil deed with a good one which will wipe the former out, and behave good naturally towards people. At-Tirmidhi relates it saying, the hadith great is hasan, which is good. In some copies he said it is good and authentic. So my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, this hadith speaks about taqwa. Taqwa is one of the most important and comprehensive Islamic concepts. The term is derived from its root, wiqaya, which means protection or to protect. Taqwa therefore means to protect one own self from the severe punishment of Allah Ta'ala by following His guidance. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu defines as fearing Allah Ta'ala, adhering to His commandments, being content with what He provides one with, and getting ready for the Day of Judgment. Sheikh Sharif Al-Arbi translates taqwa as to be conscious of Allah Ta'ala. So if one is aware of Allah Ta'ala, one is aware that Allah Ta'ala is always watching, then automatically one will do good at all times and stay away from that which is wrong. By realization of taqwa, a Muslim is granted by many bounties and blessings which he or she may gain. Among them, we realize the love of Allah Ta'ala. We'll also realize a criterion by which to judge and distinguish between right and wrong. Also realizing a way of difficulties, realizing a way out of difficulties. Difficulties and problems will be made easier for us, inshallah. Sins will be remitted, guidance and success will be acquired, all by the realization of taqwa, and also the will and permission of Allah Ta'ala. According to Ibn Rajab rahmatullah alayhi, his view, as well as other scholars, taqwa is to fulfill obligations and avoid prohibitions and doubtful matters. Is the advice of Allah Ta'ala to all human mankind. It is advice of all Prophets alayhi wasalam to their people, as how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam also used to advise and continuously remind his companions about taqwa in all his talks and on different occasions. For those who define taqwa as fearing Allah, they look at the motivational concept, because according to early scholars, the minimum level of fearing Allah is what motivates a Muslim to fulfill obligations and keep him or her away from prohibitions. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, taqwa does not imply perfection. Those who have taqwa are not safe from committing sins. However, if they do so, they repent right away and follow up the bad deed they have done with a good deed to wipe the bad one, as mentioned in this hadith, And also as mentioned in the Quran in Surah Al-Hud, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Verily, the good deeds remove the evil deeds. Sheikh Jamal Abdul Badi, a contemporary scholar, whilst explaining this hadith, said, if we do a good deed, Allah Ta'ala will reward us by guiding us to do another good deed. Hence, doing a good deed will lead to doing another good deed. He also added that doing a bad deed without regretting it and without making istighfar or wiping it out by doing a good deed will most likely lead to doing another bad deed, whether of the same type of bad deed or to a different one. To an extent that a person will not feel any more remorse, bad deeds become possible until the heart of that person is sealed and the person turns into a transgressor. Na'udhu billah. May Allah Ta'ala safeguard us all from all this. Amin. Ya Rabbil Alameen. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, the last part of the hadith tells us that it is an obligation that every Muslim should treat others, deal with them and interact with them in a good manner. Ibn Rajab rahmatullah alayhi says in his commentary, having good character is a characteristic of taqwa. Taqwa cannot be complete without it. As reported by Imam Ahmad and Abu Dawud, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is nothing heavier on the scales of deed than good character. Ibn Rajab also added that many people think taqwa implies fulfilling the rights of Allah Ta'ala without fulfilling the rights of humans. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explicitly stated that he or she must deal with people in a kind manner. This ruling is stressed in many other hadith, such as recorded by Imam Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, piety and righteousness is being of good character. In another hadith recorded by Imam Ahmad and Abu Dawud, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believer with the most complete iman, faith, is the one with the best behavior. So in conclusion, my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, to fear Allah the Almighty, to adhere to His commandments, to wipe out bad deeds with good deeds, and to deal with others in a good manner and good character are all aspects of the concept of taqwa. May Allah Ta'ala accept all our good deeds and sacrifices. May He bless us with sincerity and steadfastness. And may we gain benefit from what we've heard today, practice on it, and convey it to others as well. Amin. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.